If you've got a GivEnergy inverter and want to connect it to Home Assistant for local control and monitoring, then you're in the right place. GivTCP is an add-on for Home Assistant that provides that functionality. So keep watching and I'll walk you through the whole process of configuring it. It's been a while since I made a video about GivTCP and things have moved on a lot since then. We're now at version 3 of GivTCP and there are many improvements over version 2. We have more robust communication with the inverters using an asynchronous library, meaning that you're now less likely to get failures when sending commands. There's support for the latest GivEnergy hardware, such as the EMS and gateway, for when you have multiple inverters running in parallel. There's a new web-based configuration interface, making it a lot easier for beginners to set up, as you'll see in a minute. And there's support for the latest real-time communication or RTC functionality, which moves a number of the inverter's settings from flash into RAM storage and should really help increase the lifespan of heavily controlled inverters. And there are loads of other tweaks and fixes too, but this video is really targeted at total beginners, so those who are looking to get started for the first time with GivTCP, rather than those upgrading. If you are upgrading from version 2, then the developers already created a useful video on that process, and you can find that in the GivTCP Facebook group in the featured section, and scroll to find the post from the 25th of September 2024. If you are a total beginner and don't yet have Home Assistant set up at all, then you need to get that step sorted first. I've put together another video with my suggestions for the hardware to use and a full end-to-end guide on getting Home Assistant up and running on it, so go and check that out if you need to. Okay then, so you have Home Assistant ready to go. Let's get started on GivTCP. But first, we need to install something called Mosquito. This is also known as an MQTT broker, which is basically like a special little post office. It sits in the middle of lots of different home automation components and relays messages between them. And GivTCP needs MQTT in order to communicate with Home Assistant. So installing Mosquito is very easy. We just go down to Settings, across to Add-ons, and we go to this little blue add-on store button in the bottom right-hand corner. And Mosquito Broker is actually in the official add-on section there, but you can search for it if you want. Click on that, click on install, and then wait for it to install. So it doesn't take long to actually install, but once it has, you just click on start. Make sure it is set to start on boot, so as it starts if you next restart Home Assistant. Now, all being well, Home Assistant should just detect that MQTT has been installed. And you can see here I have got one notification. If I click on that, it says we've discovered new devices. Do I want to go and check it out? What I'm actually going to do is click on settings and go to devices and services. And you can see here MQTT has been discovered. So let's click on add and submit. And it should just add it as a new integration there, ready to go. And now we are ready to actually install GivTCP. So GivTCP is not available in the add-on store by default, so we have to tell Home Assistant where to find it. But that's easy enough to do. So installing the GivTCP add-on is also pretty straightforward. We go down to Settings, over to Add-ons, go to the add-on store, but this time we have to go to these three dots in the top right-hand corner and choose repositories. Now in here, we have to paste the URL to the GivTCP repository. Now don't worry, I will put that in the description for you so you don't have to remember it here. So you click on add and click on close. Then it's very important that you refresh the page. So you click on the little refresh icon in your browser and then you should be able to scroll down and see the GivTCP add-ons available here to install. Now we're going to install this first one here, GivTCP. We're not going to install the beta or the dev version. They're for people who really want to sort of play with new features. So let's click on GivTCP. Now we click on install and we just have to wait a few minutes for that to install. And once it's installed, you'll notice that the big difference between versions 3 and version 2, if you're coming from version 2, is that there's no configuration in here at all. So just on the info tab, we just click on start and we wait for it to boot up. we go over to the log section, we can actually watch it scanning the network for GivEnergy devices. Now on my network, this actually takes quite a little bit of time for it to scan every single IP address, but you can see it's starting to find them now. Most networks, it should be a lot quicker than this. And now you can see it's started and it's given us a web GUI config URL. So this URL here, I can actually copy that now if I want to, or if I go over to the info tab, I can just click on open web UI. Now this web user interface can be a little bit finicky. I recommend you actually right click on the go to config page and open in a new tab, which will give you a new tab up here. And then you can click on config page and it will take you to this page here. Now in this wizard, you just have to go through each of these pages in turn until you get to the end. So let's start with the first one. And we just check that it's imported our inverters correctly. Now I have got an AC3 there and it's detected that. I've gone all in one and it's detected that. It's also detected my gateway. I'm actually going to disable my gateway because I don't want it to pull in data for that. So I'm going to click on next and move on to the EV charger page. Now it does detect your EV charger as well if you've got one, so you just need to make sure it's enabled and the IP address is correct in there, and then move on to the next page, which is self-run. Now you need to toggle this option here for self-run. Leave the self-run loop timer at 30 seconds. We don't want it to run any more often than 30 seconds. And click on next. Now the MQTT section should automatically fill itself in. You can see here it's detected a username and password. This is the basic default built-in Mosquito add-on credentials. So just make sure it's enabled, it's detected, and move on to the next one. I'm not going to cover InfluxDB here. This is like a service that can be used to store your data in an external database for analysis, but I'm not going to cover that here. It's certainly not a beginner feature. Tariffs, again, it can keep track of your tariffs for you if you want to, so you can fill all of this in here and say when your off-peak session is. I prefer to do this using the Octopus Energy integration because I'm an Octopus Energy customer, but if you don't have an integration with your energy provider, then this can do it for you. Click on next to go to the web dashboard. Now GivTCP does have a built-in web dashboard, which is a bit like an in-home display for a smart meter. I don't personally use this, but if you want to use it, you can enable it. And I'd suggest changing the port here from 3000 to something else like 3010 or something. Otherwise you might get conflicts with other add-ons. So I'm gonna leave that disabled for now and move on to Palm. Now I used to use this feature actually. This is like a solar forecast automation. It'll make sure that your battery only charges to an optimal level overnight. Based on the solar forecast the next day. I don't use this anymore, but if you want to use it, you can look through the options here and configure it, but I'm just going to click on next. And the last thing to do is just to double check your time zone and click on save and restart. If we go back over to GivTCP, we look at the add-on, and we should be able to watch it restart in the logs. Okay, so after waiting a little while for it to start, we can see it is now publishing Home Assistant discovery messages here in the logs, which means it's ready to start looking at some data. So let's navigate to settings and over to devices and services. And if we look at the devices section here, we should be able to filter by GivTCP. And this will show us all of the GivTCP devices that have been created. So let's start by looking at this one here, GivTCP Power. And we can see that we are currently outputting 342 watts of battery power on that particular battery. We can see grid voltage, frequency, all sorts of useful stuff here. If we go back out and we can look at the control section, this is where you'll find all of your controls for setting things like the charge rate there. You can set the battery pause mode, so I could pause the batteries there if I wanted to. I could enable eco mode on this battery. Most people will probably have eco mode enabled to meet the house demand. This particular battery is actually in a scheduled discharge mode right at the moment. Yeah, you can see mode timed export, but normally you'll probably find that this is in eco mode for you. And let's go back and we can look at energy data. So we've got total energy ever. So this is output nearly, 6 megawatts, or more than 6 megawatts of energy total in its lifetime. That's quite a bit. But yeah, there's plenty of things there for you to take a look at. So it's always a good idea to check that these entities exist, so as you've got a starting point for whatever you're going to use it for. You'll probably already have an idea as to what you want to do with these controls and data feeds, but please go take a look through my other videos if you want inspiration. I'd really suggest starting with the excellent PowerFlow Card Plus, which is a great visualization card showing you at a glance where all of your power is going in your home. Or you might want to configure the energy dashboard to help you keep track of how much energy you have used and where it all came from and went to. Anyway, I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for free to see more from me. These amazing people here are my channel members and patrons, and a massive thank you to them for supporting me. If you'd like to become a member or a patron too, then check out the links down in the description. In return, you'll get early access to my videos and some bonus content too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.